This video is regarding the notification passed by ICSI yesterday, that is 3rd of February 2020. Now, this notification talks about scrapping of or discontinuation of CS Foundation examination. Now, what follows CS Foundation examination, which is discontinued, is CSEET. It stands for Company Secretary Executive Entrance Test. Now, foundation was the barrier which you need to cross to enter CS Executive. So now this barrier is replaced by CSEET, which is the examination which is to be cleared to enter CS Executive examination. Let us now quickly see the differences between our old CS Foundation exam and the new CSEET, that is Company Secretary Executive Entrance Test. Old CS Foundation exam was conducted 2 times a year. In regard to which our CSEET will be conducted 4 times a year. We all knew that CS Foundation exam was conducted in the month of June and December under the old scheme. CSEET comes with 4 times a year, that's in the month of January, May, July and November. May and November will act as the main dates of examination, like Chartered Accountancy examination, in which if the student fails, can take up the examination in the consecutive time. Meaning, if a student fails in the month of May, they can take up the exam in the month of July. And if a student fails in the month of November, they can take the exam in the month of January without postponing or without delaying their CS Executive examination. So, the age-old joke that people used to crack on CS students doing December, June, DJ, DJ will not work anymore. Let us see the next difference between CS Foundation examination and CS Executive Entrance Test. Previously, there were a lot of exemptions for CS Foundation examination. Person who is a graduate, a person who is a postgraduate, and people doing Chartered Accountancy or Cost and Management Accounting examination, if they had cleared their first level, that is CACPT or the Foundation exam under the respective stream, were exempted from taking up CS Foundation examination. Now, what would happen with respect to this provision and our CSEET? CSEET is little too stingy with respect to exemptions from entrance. CS Foundation exam gave exemptions for graduate and postgraduates, whereas CS Executive Entrance Test limits the exemption to only Chartered Accountancy and Cost and Management Accountancy qualified students, meaning graduates, postgraduates who previously claimed exemption from CS Foundation cannot claim exemption anymore. They would have to take up CSEET in order to write CS Executive Examination. Next up, people who had qualified CPT or passed out of CA Foundation or CMA Foundation still will not get any exemption from CSEET, and they have to go through CSEET exam. So we can say the only people who are eligible to claim exemption from CSEET is a qualified CA or a qualified CMA. Now, talking about the dates which are concerning our CSEET examination. As CSEET examination is conducted 4 times a year, the registration has to be done well in prior, and the registration dates will open 4 months in prior to the examination date for the main attempts like May and the November, and for the other 2 attempts, which is our July and January, the examination forms will open 2 months before the examination month, and it will close 15 days before the month in which the examination is conducted. So, if you are taking up examination in the month of May, you would have to register anytime after 21st of January, that is 4 months before the examination month. But the registration will close 15 days before the examination month, that is examination month being May, the last day to register will be April 15th, the first day to register will be anytime after January 21st. Same thing will correspond for the other 3 examinations. But we need to note that for the July and the January attempt, the registrations will open only 2 months before the examination date and not 4 months. After writing this examination, which is to be conducted around 10th of the month of examination, the results would be out within 10 days. That is, you write the examination around 10th, the results will be out on 20th of the month, and you need to register for CS Executive within the end of the same month in which you wrote the examination. So you need to register anytime before 4 months before if the exam is in the month of May, 4 months before the form opens, and it closes 15 days before the examination. Once you register, you write the examination on the 10th of the month, around 10th, little before or little later. Examination result will be out by 20th, and you need to register for CS Executive within the end of the month. So examination around 10th, results by 20th, and registration for CS executive by 30th. Everything would happen within a maximum gap of 10 days. And what's ahead is, once you clear your CSEET examination and you register for CS executive exam, you will be eligible to take up both the modules of CS executive exam in the same year if you written the exam in the month of May or July. Meaning, if you write your CSEET in May or July and your results are out in the same month, you will be eligible to write CS executive both the modules in the same year, December. If you clear your CSEET examination in the month of November or in the month of January, then you will be eligible to take up both the modules of CS executive like this. If you clear in the month of November, the next year's June. If you clear in the month of January, the same year's June is when you will be eligible to take up your CS executive exams, both the modules. Talking about the examination will consist of four papers, which are here, and the examination will not have any negative marking. And what's really interesting to me is they've told in the notification that examination will consist of multiple choice questions, which is pretty evident. And the new addition is there will be audio clips, video clips, and descriptive questions in the examination format. Now, what is more about this audio clips, video clips? Let me tell that to you after I tell you the timings of the examination. Examination will be for 120 minutes plus 15 minutes. In total, coming up to 135 minutes. Now, what is this 15 minutes for after the 120 minutes? This will be for a viva voice, meaning there will be an oral examination. As the entire examination is told to be computerized, we can expect that there would be a question popping out on the screen, which you need to answer, which will be recorded through the microphone and to be heard by the evaluator before your marks have been put for that particular examination. So I repeat, examination is for four papers, 120 minutes plus additional 15 minutes is for viva, which is video clip, audio clip, which is to be newly added to our scheme of examination. So this is going to be an examination where the presentation is very importantly tested over here in paper, as well as when you talk live to the camera right in front of you. Thank you.